Patent licensing is one of the ways by which patent owner transfers to the other entity right to exploit the patented invention in exchange of royalty. Along with the patent rights, often there is also transfer of know-how, experience, methodology, processes, etc. In this video, we will see how and why patent licensing is important, specifically for pharmaceutical industry, because innovation shelf life is longer in this industry and lots of regulatory approvals also play a very vital role in addition to the patent. As you know that patent is a statutory grant and it extends a set of legal rights. Patents are granted to novel, inventive and industrially useful inventions by the government. Grant of a patent and rights so extended are territorial in nature, which means that Indian patent is valid only in India. Term of patent is usually 20 years, after which a patent expires, and after expiry, anyone can use such expired patent without requiring permission of a patent holder. Patent holder has right to prevent third parties from making, using, selling, offering for sale or importing the patented invention in the country where he has patent protection. This means that if any third party has to use the patented invention, permission from the patent holder is required, and this permission or consent of a patent holder is called as license. Once a patent is granted, in order to generate revenue out of it, it has to be commercialized. For a patent holder, there are a couple of options by using which he can make money from his patent. The first patent is patent licensing, wherein patent holder transfers patent rights to third party for a specific period of time without transferring ownership of the patent. Second way is patent assignment, wherein patent holder permanently transfers ownership of his patent to the third party and such third party becomes owner of the patent. The third way to bring patented product in the market is joint venture, wherein both patent holder and third party, they join hands to build and establish new venture in collaboration. All these three modes may be explored by the patent holder as well as third parties to find out the most effective way of working together. In most of the cases, licensing or assignment of the patent takes place from patent holder to the industry because they both have good synergy, where patent holder possesses innovation or industry possesses business skills. Patent holder may be an academic institution, company, or it may be an individual inventor. In addition to patent, in most of the cases, know-how, goodwill, experience, methodology, process, confidential information, trade secret of patent holder are also transferred to enable the industry partner or patent buyer to exploit the patented technology in best possible manner. For both parties, that is patent holder and patent buyer, it is important to take decision on whether they want to enter into a patent licensing or patent assignment kind of relationship. Patent licensing is a transfer of rights for a specific period of time, whereas assignment is permanent transfer of rights. Please note that assignment can be full or partial. Patent holder may transfer ownership of the patent fully or a part of it to the buyer and keep rest of it for himself. The license agreement in a licensing deal could be exclusive or non-exclusive in nature. These two terms are used very often in the industry. As the name indicates, exclusive license is the one which is granted by the patent holder to only one party, and such party can prevent everyone else, including the patent holder, from using the patented invention in any manner. In this case, the licensee almost becomes owner of the patent. On the contrary, the non-exclusive license is the one wherein patent holder may grant such license to more than one party. In the pharmaceutical industry specifically, the trend is to opt for exclusive license so that companies may have competitive advantage in the market and prevent everyone else from entering that particular space. Patent licensing is the way to use each other's strengths and work in complete synergy. Patent licensing may help patent holder to facilitate the process of patent commercialization, wherein production, marketing, sale of the product is taken care of by the licensee. The company or licensee also gets access to innovation and save upon R&D effort. By acquiring right to use the patented invention, the patent licensing also helps companies to overcome patent infringement risk. Even though there are lots of advantages of patent licensing, sometimes the relationship between the parties turns out to be really disastrous. If patent is assigned, the patent holder may lose ownership of the patent. Things become even worse if the payment terms are not conducive. Company or licensee may not be able to market and sell the product as anticipated in the beginning. Sometimes the patented technology fails to work effectively on large scale, or market demand may decline. Due to all these reasons, licensing may turn out to be really a very bad option. Pharmaceutical is a very important industry as far as patent licensing is concerned. In case of pharmaceutical patents, shelf life of patent is much more compared to any other industry, and this is one of the most important factors due to which this industry stands out. Further, public health and drug pricing has been given a lot of emphasis in the industry, due to which the process of patent licensing may take an unexpected turn. Specifically in case of pharmaceutical industry, the patent license could be either voluntary, involuntary or compulsory license. So voluntary license is the one which is granted by patent holder to the company under ordinary circumstances. So ordinary circumstances refer to a situation wherein there is no epidemic, pandemic kind of situation, or there is no national emergency or extreme urgency. Voluntary license can be either exclusive or non-exclusive. Involuntary license could be granted in case of patent infringement, and this license is usually granted by the patent holder to the company under specific circumstances where the company infringes patent rights of patent holder and wants to continue using the patented invention. This kind of license is granted only when there is likelihood of patent holder filing a lawsuit against the company for patent infringement, and in order to avoid this, the company may take license or permission to use from the patent holder. And compulsory license is granted by the government under very specific circumstances. Compulsory license in India is granted under three circumstances. Under Section 84, if 3 years' time has expired after patent is granted and patent holder himself fails to work on the invention because of which reasonable requirements of public are not met, or product is not available to the public at affordable price, or invention is not worked in the territory of India, any company can request controller to grant compulsory license to it. Under Section 92, compulsory license to manufacture and sell the product is granted to any company which applies for such license, and the license under Section 92 is granted in case of extreme urgency or national emergency. So you can consider COVID-19 also as extreme urgency or national emergency kind of situation, in which compulsory license may be granted to a company that has manufacturing capacity to make the product which is used for the treatment of COVID-19. Grant of compulsory license under Section 92A is for export of patented pharmaceutical products in certain exceptional circumstances. So I will explain you some case studies wherein the provisions of compulsory license they were used in the past. Now let's see some of the case studies wherein different kinds of patent licenses were worked out by different pharmaceutical companies in the past. Novartis had a patent on chronic obstructive pulmonary disease drug Onbris, and Cipla began to sell generic version of the drug in spite of the patent that was in the name of Novartis. And when the lawsuit was initiated by Novartis, Cipla offered to pay a reasonable royalty to Novartis. So this is a kind of involuntary license that was executed between Cipla and Novartis. Cipla appealed to Indian government to revoke Novartis patent later on under Section 66, that is revocation of patent in public interest, and Section 92, special provisions for compulsory license on notification by central government. However, the Indian government did not find merit in Cipla's argument that a compulsory license should be issued under Section 92. In another case between Celgene Corporation and Sun Pharma, Celgene Corporation has a patent on Revlimid. Upon ANDA filing by Sun Pharma to manufacture generic version of this particular drug, Celgene filed a lawsuit for patent infringement against Sun Pharma. In this case, Celgene agreed to grant a license to Sun Pharma for a specific amount of money to be paid by Sun Pharma as royalty to manufacture and sell the drug subject to US FDA approval. By providing this license, Celgene would allow Sun Pharma to manufacture and sell an unlimited quantity of generic version of this drug in the US from January 31st, 2020. Before this case between Celgene and Sun Pharma, other Indian companies like Cipla, Natco, Cadila, Dr. Reddy's Lab, and US-based Alvogen company also they settled patent litigation with Celgene, and in all the cases Celgene granted a patent license to all these companies required to manufacture and sell an unlimited quantity of generic drug in the US beginning after January 31st, 2026. So as we saw in this video, that patent licensing is an option which synergizes the relationship between patent holder and company, or we can call it as industrial partner. However, the risks and advantages shall be weighed properly by both the parties so that the relationship is beneficial to both parties. I would like to thank all of you for watching this video today. You can put your comments, feedback in the comment section below. If you want me to make a video on a specific topic, you can put that in the chat box. And you can subscribe and like this video channel. Take care of yourself. Goodbye.